Yay, such bow.
Yay, here to the rescue. Team player.
And I'm amazed that you didn't heal me.
What do you
thought
mean?
You would do a mean, just run away.
With the last one
no, 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 no. Hello guys, and welcome back to some more Back for Blood Co-op. What are you looking at?
Opinion.
Why is that a...
Not looking at anything.
Why is that a... Why?
You see it
wasn't a marker, it was like a weird...
Yeah, you put it.
There's the ready one.
Oh. Didn't even know that was a thing.
Kinda sad.
Oh yeah, and we died before when we tried to do this.
Not one for speech. What? Nah. So how
about we just go? Yeah. You know, no. I mean, first try.
Exactly.
Yeah, save Fort Hope. Why can't we just let Fort Hope get like destroyed and then kill it afterwards? Only a few innocent people will die. Are they truly innocent if they're humans?
We're waiting for Soy to be done. He's a slowpoke.
Not my fault. I like animations. Okay, maybe it is my fault that I like animations, but not really. Okay.
We all good?
Rogers is dead.
Ooh. That just leaves us to save the day. I don't care how big it is. Wait, what do you mean Rogers is dead? He's not dead. As we saw.
Okay.
He's dead, I shot him.
Yeah, can I have money again? I'm kind of used to getting team stuff. I forget about
it. Oh boy, hero. Oh boy. You're lucky that I don't really need half of this stuff.
Just give him 100.
Oh wait, whoops, I just got okay, I need that.
Yeah, me too.
I'm okay with that.
Okay, here you go, hero. Here you go. There you go. I have more if you want more. I got even more where that came from.
Should we get a... Wait, what is it called? I'm gonna take that.
More what?
All the defab. No. I would rather count on you guys not dying.
Oh, I'm gonna take the defibrillator then. It's mine now. I got it.
Can we go now?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure. You know, I got fast reloading weapons for once, so I'm ready, I'm ready. Oh my god, no, I'm not ready. I regret my decision to jump down.
Fine. I have a machine gun, I'm happy. We got a pipe bomb here.
Oh nice. The only issue I have with the machine gun is that it reloads too slow. And especially in this fast paced thingy.
That's why you get the fast reload mag.
I got both, the fast reload mag and the 20% extra, but it still reloads too slow.
Mm.
Ow, oh, dang it,
got stuck. I love this fucking sniper rifle on this level.
That goddamn sniper rifle does too much damage.
Yeah, if you four hit the tentacles.
I'm breaking out. Whoop.
Oh, you broke out.
God damn! I can't even shoot it, because when you shoot it, it immediately acknowledges that it has so much damage that it needs to hide.
It's a good weapon! For this level, and only for this level. It's kind of sad. So many fucking zombies everywhere. No.
This is disgusting.
Any of you wanna? No? You wanna?
Oops, that was a Evangelo. That was an Evangelo. That's a shotgun, yeah.
Down here. Oh, there's a shotgun for hero, that's nice.
The shotgun?
The auto shotgun that you like so much. I'm gonna heal you. It's where Satchel is, somewhere.
It's below me. I pooped it out.
It's kinda nice. So hero's gonna run around with Satchel's poop.
Yep.
Worth it.
I've decided to just shoot all the infected instead. You know, I think that's more good for this kind of stuff.
Punch.
Oh.
Where is it? Is it gone? Oh my goodness, there's still so many of them though.
I kind of want the sniper thing even though it's bad.
It's very good for this. Can you have two weapons?
I have a pistol and...
Oh, you don't have the card we have?
I don't think so.
Hero, before you go, you need to first of all heal and then you need to get these painkillers and use them.
I'm looking. Where is it?
I marked it over here. There.
No big deal.
Did you heal too?
Patching myself up.
Okay.
There you go.
Alright. You already got everything. The pipe bomb. Do you guys have the pipe bomb? Oh, you do. Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go. I don't care about that dude.
Isn't he gonna follow us down?
Probably. So you take care of all zombies, me and Hero shoot them out.
You sure? I'm the damage guy. Are you sure that's a good idea?
Yes. I think so. Maybe. I don't know. How did that damage back up? Oh, that was two shots.
I'll try to kill the dude then. Might as well.
Yeah, don't stay close. He eats you.
I didn't think I was that close. Oops.
Fucking hell.
There aren't any zombies this time, it's weird.
Did you scream once?
Oh, we got close to him.
There are no zombies, it's very weird.
I need that. I think it's because we're doing this so fast.
No zombies or no. Oh, no. Oh.
Did you try to throw a grenade into its mouth?
I thought it would first.
I didn't say that was a waste. Would you tell me it was a waste when I threw it? I feel
it
like
a
special
waste.
Female treatment.
Hero, that was a waste. You happy? Ow.
Thank you. I feel very happy now. I feel very happy.
It's sad that you get happy from me dissing Hero.
No, it's also sad that I'm...
That was a waste, Hero.
I got you.
Oh, that's funny. I owe you one. Again. I definitely need health, though. Am I going to be the noob that dies this time? Oh, that's sad.
Don't know.
I'm going to be the noob.
Is there any, like... Has it shown the weak spot yet?
No, it's going to be... There it is.
I'll go to the other side.
I really like it.
Yeah, it's amazing. Where's the bandages? I heard someone say bandages.
Yeah, I heard bandages too. Don't know where they are though.
I found them.
I found them too. It's under them. What? How am I losing so much health?
Because these zombies hurt a lot.
Did I? Zombie. Okay, I didn't see them again. At a fort.
Okay, I got one, but more.
Last one is under him.
Okay. Last one? We already did it.
One more.
One more.
Ooh. I don't need it right now. Ouch.
I have 8 health. Never mind. I don't have any health.
Yay, head to the rescue. Team player.
And I'm amazed that you didn't heal me.
What do you
thought
mean?
You would do a mean, just run away.
With the last one.
No.
Just for your meds.
I don't play like that. Even as a joke.
Is the last one under him?
Yeah.
Only in games where I know you can spawn in a little bit, like Halo. In Halo, I might do that. This. This might hurt me more than hurt you
when
or whatever.
We're done now.
Oh.
Look at it.
Turn into blood or whatever it is. Never mind, it's alive?
It's
what?
Still going.
Oh, never mind, we're good. This has nothing to do with noodles. Freaking Evangelo, I hate that guy.
But
look at Hugo.
Oh no. Died twice.
Out there. Nah,
many.
But I intend to find out.
Cut that macho BS.
Somebody's got to do something.
And you're that somebody. So what makes you so special?
You do.
Immune.
All of you. Didn't say I wanted to do it alone, did I?
Hell yeah.
Fuck you and that silver tongue of yours. Rays of fucking sunshine today, aren't we?
We done. Killed all zombies.
That's it.
That's it.
Come on.
Don't like it. No.
Oh, thank goodness, this is another cutscene. I was so disappointed with that ending there.
You forget something? Maybe I should go to Bridgetown. At least they pay.
So Hugo right there.
Come get some breakfast. Always there when they need me, but they ask me what I want.
Coming. Don't suppose anyone's got any eggs. Oh, and bacon. Oh, I would kill for bacon.
Kill is it. Okay. Kill a pig for bacon.
That's how you do it, Soy.
Nah, I thought bacon came from the sky.
Yeah, it just rains.
It just rains down with bacon now and again. That is still a very unsatisfying ending,
yeah,
I have to say.
Such an unsatisfying ending.
It's not at all what I expected, that's for sure.
But it's not technically the ending too, though.
Then what is the ending?
I mean, that is the ending of the base game, but they're probably gonna add DLCs and shit. It's gonna continue.
Yeah, but if you have an actual ending as a DLC, I count the ending still as the real ending.
Oh, yeah, me too.
Because that is very ridiculous if you do that way. Then it's just proof that they didn't get to finish the complete game in time, and they had to add it on as a DLC. Oh, I'm looking forward to this. Stop talking, Phillips. You're apparently dead, according to lore, even though you were never shown to be dead.
Who's dead?
Phillips. The military. Oh no, Rogers died.
I'm so confused.
I don't know. It said that someone died, and I think it was Rogers.
Your peepee died.
Oh yeah, but I've been looking forward to talk about this game for a little while, because a lot of people would compare this to Left 4 Dead, and I would say fair play, same developers, same-ish game. But again, they're like two completely different apples from the same tree, in my opinion. If you know that analogy. This is the apple that's more for hardcore players. The kind of players that are into like first-person shooters, they want to shoot, they want to go through a mission. A little bit like Left 4 Dead. But this one is for a little bit more of a hardcore audience. And the difficulty I'm going to come into later is definitely higher than if you played Left 4 Dead. Also, story-wise, both have somewhat of a weak story. None of them are really that interesting, both Left 4 Dead and this game. Weak stories. Gameplay-wise, they're pretty much all the same, just a little bit different. I love how you posted the... Thank you. Thank you for that. But yeah, this game is like Left 4 Dead, but a little bit tougher, a little bit more modern, I would say. And I also want to say a little bit less fun. I'll name my reasons why. I just kind of wanted to mention a little bit about the game. The comparison between the two before I continued. So, let me talk about what I like about this game. And then I'll say what I dislike afterwards. You guys want to help me out? Want to begin? You guys want to say something to begin with? No?
I pretty much agree with everything you say, so... Or that you are going to say.
Alright, but first of all, difficulty. Difficulty in this game is like, how do you say, it's like if you ask someone to throw a ball at you, and whether or not they hit is completely up to if they can aim or not, and whether or not they have a bad hand, or their arm hurts, or anything that could suddenly get in the way of giving you the difficulty you want. Recruit difficulty, it's like saying that they have like 30 centimeters in front of you and can throw it. Depending on the missions, of course. There are certain missions in recruit difficulty that's like extremely tough. But recruit difficulty, at least when we began playing, was too easy. It wasn't fun. It's like I just said, you ask someone to stand 30 centimeters in front of you and you throw the ball with a very weak throw, boop, and then you you catch it or whatever, or get hit by it. And then you go to veteran difficulty, which is like, now you suddenly go like 20 meters over, and you have to throw, and if you don't hit me, you're gonna get a harder difficulty than what I asked for. The person throws, boom, harder difficulty than what you asked for, because it rarely hits that specific difficulty you want. Which is just a little harder than recruit difficulty. Oh, well, in the beginning it was much harder, but now recruit difficulty seems to be a little bit harder than when we first started. But yeah, It was certainly too easy in the beginning, and this difficulty was a little bit too hard. But we wanted the harder difficulty because it enticed team play. Then there's the card system. I personally... Now, this is a personal opinion, of course, but I personally dislike the fact that I use cards, and I'm more of an old-school skill tree system kind of guy. A type of guy. I prefer skill trees, and you actually keep the experience, and... You can level up your character and get like abilities that way that permanently applies to you. So that's just my personal opinion, but I wish it had something like that because it feels like the cards mean nothing. Like to me, it feels like you don't technically earn experience when you go out and shoot zombies or anything. It's just you gain some points for completing the mission. Now, some may say that that is pretty much the same thing. You use those points to buy cards, don't you? Right choice. Yes, but the cards are depending on whether or not you want to use them, and half the cards you get, you're never going to use anyway, and then you're going to go for a specific build, which I do like about the card system. They can make a build, but I still wish it was a skill-based thing where there were a lot of skills and they were specific to a certain build. But I have heard some people say that they actually do like the card system. Other reviewers, as an example, said that they like the card system. They just wish they did more with it. I completely dislike it. I still wish they made a normal skill tree. Myself. I do like the whole idea with the corruption cards, though. I do like that idea. Like, a lot. I do like the idea of every single playthrough being random in some aspect. And I can also see where that could be fun. Or how it could be challenging. So I like that idea. But the whole difficulty thing makes the corruption cards kind of meaningless. Because, again, if you get a corruption card, like, it spawns a boss. Alright, it's up to chance what boss you get. And if you get a hag, you're pretty much screwed either way. Like, playing easy difficulty, you might get screwed. Playing harder difficulty, you're probably gonna get screwed. Playing nightmare difficulty, you're definitely gonna get screwed. Like, nightmare difficulty is almost impossible. I have tried it. It's not that fun. You thought veteran was hard? Nightmare difficulty is like... one step forward, four steps back. Which is another thing I dislike about the game. The fact that you complete a mission, go to the next one, you die in that mission, and then you have to start all over again to a mission before, on a difficult basis, is kind of ridiculous to me. And I'm very disappointed for that. Like, very, very disappointed. Because I get that you want to lose something every single time you... You fail, alright? I get that idea. But the fact that you play a higher difficulty because, as an example, the recruit difficulty is too easy, so you pick veteran. But now, as a side effect, you also have to go through the thingy that, okay, every two levels you have to complete, otherwise you go back to the beginning of that level. I think that is so ridiculous. I think that is something you should be able to turn off. And I think they made a big mistake doing that. I really honestly do. I think that is the worst implementation of difficulty I have ever seen in a game next to Call of Duty to spamming grenades. So there are other effects that I do like in the difficulty where you get more damaged, more friendly fire, more enemies will spawn, which is also another negative thing about this game. Oh, I thought one of you guys said something there. The other bad thing that I dislike about the game is the fact that all the time, and I mean almost all the time, you are spammed with big guys on higher difficulties. They have also sort of done it with the lower difficulties lately, at least in the last couple of levels. But compared to recruit and veteran or whatever we're playing on right now, we did play on before we got to that level where they couldn't complete. It was crazy, all right. It was just crazy how many of those like special zombies spawned. There were way too many of them spawning. I did not enjoy any of the spawning in this game whatsoever. Again, it was part of the random throw. Do you hit this difficulty? Do you hit this person you're trying to hit with the ball? All right, you missed by this much, so now we're gonna spawn a whole shit ton of enemies on you, and then next time you start the match. Or you hit right beside it, so let's spawn less enemies this time. It is way, way, way too random. Enemy spawning is way too random, and they need to have a max number of something, or at least lessen that number of something on the map all at once, and then add more smaller zombies. Because it was just so annoying. Like, I got so annoyed by it, to be honest. Like, so freaking annoyed. Because again, with the whole thingy where you have to move two steps back in case you die, when we tried to go through that on the veteran difficulty, we got spammed with those big guys and we died. Then we got spammed again and we died. It's just awful. Awful getting spammed. And they're also sort of bullet sponges. So that's also something I dislike a lot. Don't make enemies... Like, I get they weren't really bullet sponges, but they were kind of bullet sponges at times, especially... when you spawn a ton of them, then it's almost like one entity with a lot of health.
And especially when they are armored.
Yeah, and when they're armored too. Like, I don't mind the armor because it's not that hard to get rid of the armor, but on top of everything else, if they are armored, it's almost impossible. Okay. So that's also something I really dislike. Thank you for the copyright. Well, I got it anyway from the credit screen, I think, for the tiny credit screen. So those were some of the things I dislike about the game, in general. Now, I already mentioned that I liked the whole card system, but the build system you can do. You can build certain things and build certain elements and things. I like that. I like the fact that you have to walk around in a base in order to do a mission. I hate just normal boring menus, so I like that they have actually made it so you can walk around in here. Even though I do wish there were more to do. I really do wish there were more to do. And I liked the first half of the campaign. The second half was a little bit meh. But the first half of the campaign I really did enjoy. One thing I didn't mention yet, by the way. One thing that is also bad that I didn't mention. Certain bugs. Alright. Specifically, the bot you play with. Just specifically the bot. It teleports around. It teleports to places where you are not supposed to go. And then if a player spawns as the bot, they can't get out of that area. Which then make the player stuck in that specific area. And they can't continue unless they die. I've also been stuck in a wall off camera. I have, we've also seen an enemy fall through the map. So there are certain bugs here and there. But besides the bot, none of them are too significant. So that is something to always keep in mind.
Don't forget the connection bugs that Hero gets all the time and you having issues launching the game sometimes.
Oh yeah, yeah. When I tried launching a game at a point in time, I couldn't launch it and it kept crashing. I don't know, but I don't know if that was the game's fault or if that was just Game Pass's fault though. Same with the connection fault? Issue. Because we've had trouble connecting. Where it said we weren't in the game and stuff. But I partly think that's Xbox's fault. But that is something to also note. So if that happens to you, if you're not using Xbox Game Pass, then it is definitely the game's fault. The graphics looks good, though. And it has DLSS. I don't think it has ray tracing.
No ray tracing.
Which is completely okay. A game doesn't have to have ray tracing, even though it adds a little bit more to the game. At least in my opinion, with the shadows and everything.
Nukes your FPS.
And get rid of your FPS. But this game seems like it can take it. There have been certain areas where we got like complete drops in frames.
But like it's usually just level. In the beginning of the...
like as soon as
the beginning
outside.
Of the map. When it loads shit. It usually lags for a couple of seconds.
That is true, that is true. And it can be fun too. I also said in the beginning that this should be played on veteran difficulty, but I completely take that back. There is no difficulty in this game you should play it at. Like, there's no difficulty you should play it at. All of the difficulties are bad, in my opinion.
Yeah.
There needs to be one difficulty that's harder than Recruit, but that's easier than Veteran.
Yep.
But there are no difficulty like that, so you're gonna have to deal with one or the other. Either too easy or a little bit too hard.
Or you could do like us, play the first half of the game on Veteran and then go down one.
Yeah, you can do that too. But we didn't go down by choice, it was just because we couldn't complete that map, because the game, like, bugged out once where you got teleported into an area you couldn't go out of.
Yep.
And then we got spammed with big enemies all the time, and kept dying.
And just one of those were the one with the bridge. And we got how many exploded dudes? It was like 5 or 6.
I think it was 5 or 6, yeah.
3 army dudes, like the big army dudes. And a couple of the jumpy dudes. It's fucking ridiculous.
Very ridiculous. And I don't play this game to kill all the special zombies. I play it to kill the normal zombies. Now, I don't mind if there are special zombies thrown into the mix, personally, but I prefer just being able to shoot normal zombies most of the time. But it felt like it was half the time big zombies or big thingies, and then the other half was small zombies. So that's also a little bit disappointing. Story already mentioned, it was kind of bland. Not too much was going on, but it was all right. And like I mentioned, graphics are all right now again, but if you got extremely close to objects, you can sort of see, like this light here at the front of the car, that it's not completely round, and certain objects do have a little less quality, but that's not like a big deal, by the way. Like, far away you can't see that. At all. And the customization is a little nice extra. Same with the gun, like, customization. Unnecessary, but always, like, a little bit extra. I don't know what else that's nice to say. The models look nice. The shooting, in the beginning, they had an issue where it looked like they were shooting out of the hand. But now they fixed it, like, as soon as they released the main game, because I played the beta. But yeah, as soon as they released the game, they fixed a bug like that. So I liked that they fixed that. So the shooting feels okay, but to me it still feels like the weapon is a bit too big. The other two don't have that issue, but that's just me.
I mean, some of the weapons are too big. Like, the AK it's good. It's good size. But the fucking, like, for example, the Glock, it's huge for some reason.
Also, the starting rifle, the M4 carbine, I also think it's pretty big.
I guess. And then they absolutely mismodeled the M16. Which is kind of sad, because it's a beautiful rifle.
I'm fine with that. It's not. I'm not a big gun nerd and stuff. I'm fine with it. And compared to Left 4 Dead, this is a game like Left 4 Dead, but like I said, a completely different apple from the same tree. This game is less fun than Left 4 Dead, in my opinion. It feels a little bit more sloppy than Left 4 Dead, in my opinion. Guns feel too stiff in this one. In Left 4 Dead, they felt a little bit more fun to use. Like, there were recoil, like heavy recoil on them and stuff. You can say it's kind of a little bit like old school, like when it comes to Left 4 Dead's gunplay, but I kind of liked that aspect of it.
But you have also turned off recoil.
Well, no, I haven't. Oh, you mean the recoil isn't turned off, it just resets.
Yeah, it moves down by itself.
Yeah, that's on Left 4 Dead 2.
It feels like the game feels a lot better when you turn that off.
No, it doesn't. It feels the same to me. It doesn't change anything of how it feels to shoot the gun at all. I still get the recoil, it just resets. Which I don't care that much about. That is not what I'm talking about. I'm just generally talking about how it feels to shoot. Oops. Animations though. Gorgeous. I love the animations. They feel smooth. They feel nice. A big plus. Way better than Left 4 Dead's animations. By a ton. but yeah, I would definitely say that Left 4 Dead is the one I would play out of the two. This game does have the gun customization system, even though it's a little bit sloppy. You can't really pick what to have on your gun in a normal fashion. Only if you buy it. Yeah, here in the tutorial thingy, of course.
You can find it in the levels.
Yeah, but if I have this as an example, and I want to drop this off on my gun, I can't do that.
Yeah, I do.
I can't
wish
drop
you could
this
drop
attachment
them.
Off. Which I think is kind of sloppy. Personally, I think that's a little bit lazy. Because I do think that would be something a lot of people would love. I can also see how it can be a little bit overpowered, but then it could change the spawn rates of certain epic or legendary things. Yeah, I don't think I have much else to say about it other than it's an alright game. It's not as good as Left 4 Dead in my opinion, but it is pretty good still. Left 4 Dead is a bit more fun. This is more challenging than Left 4 Dead, but I enjoyed this a lot less than Left 4 Dead. And if you prefer team play over just shooting through zombies, this is also the game for you. This is about team play, about working together. A little bit more hardcore. Ouch. Wait, you can't shoot me?
I'm shooting next to you.
Oh, you can. Okay. Sorry, my screen, it looked like you hit me because I was bleeding. I don't know. Do you guys have something to add to it? Otherwise, I'm just going to give it its rating, even though I should probably have given it that in the beginning, but...
No, I don't have anything to add.
Yeah, again, I need to say this. It's easier to pick on it for the bad things than the good things, so there might be some good things I haven't mentioned. But if you guys are wondering about anything, you can also look through the back in the playthrough where I do say a few other things while we record the videos. That's something you can check out. Kaboom. But yeah, I'm gonna give it a 6 out of 10. Reason for that being that it doesn't feel like a finished game. In my opinion. Very important, my opinion. It feels like they could have done more with the card system. It feels like they could have done a little bit more with the gunplay. It feels like they could have done a little bit more with the attachments. Everything just feels like they could have been done a little bit more. Same with the AI. They could have done a little bit more with the AI. The maps, they could have done a little bit more of the maps. Oh, that's something I didn't touch, by the way. The maps, you usually play through the same maps, but in a different kind of setup. Too a lot. I don't mind that. That's cleverly used as a reusable asset stuff thingy. Very clever.
They are
of them to
usually
do.
Slightly different.
Yeah, they are slightly
go
different.
Like a different path.
Which is okay, but I do prefer like more maps too. Like if they could have more maps. It's a slight example. It's not as big as the bud or anything. But if they didn't reuse the maps as much also, or the certain areas of the maps. Also feels a little bit like they didn't have enough time. Like everything just feels like it needs more time. Yeah, try to shoot me, are you? But they have a few extra things here and there that Left 4 Dead does not have. Which makes this definitely more modernized, a little bit more customizable. And a little bit less shooty-shooty and more thinky-thinky, in my opinion. That's why I give it a 6. It's not as good as certain other games I've played. But I still had a decent amount of fun. It can be frustrating at times. It can be annoying at times. You can yell at your friends at times. But overall, it wasn't a bad game. And it wasn't like an epic game either. It was just an alright game. It's a game that could be fun. But I've certainly had my issues with it. Let's just say it like that. This is not my kind of game, like in general. Alright, well, if that is it for you two as well, right? Yes, no?
Yes, no, yes, maybe.
I'm guessing that's a yes. Alright, then I'm gonna end this video here. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it, or hearing my opinion on the game, even though I guess most people skip over it, which is completely fine. But yeah, this is my opinion of the game. I hope you guys enjoyed it nonetheless, or the gameplay, or the playthrough in general. I do a lot of other playthroughs where I also get my opinions, and just play through them for fun with my friends or alone. Don't play any specific kind of game, just all games, you know? So consider liking and subscribing to see more of those, or just taking them out without liking or subscribing. You don't even have to do those things, even though I would prefer it though. Then I hope you guys stay awesome, and like I mentioned, hope to see you in another one of my playthroughs.